using his fantastic aerial drift and be safe. Ike does the exact same thing. He does not have the fantastic aerial drift or the movement that Wolf does. Instead, he just tosses out the meaty hitboxes that are, you know, hitting you from halfway across the stage.
Yeah, big enough hitbox so that he can safely kind of step back with proper spacing. But Wolf does have blasters, so we'll see how well Puppy does.
Oh, yeah, Wolf got that gat on him. Like that, there was a poll the other day where people were saying, like, Wolf blasters kind of overrated. Hard disagree. Like, I still think that it's probably not the best projectile in the game. That goes to Nikita, and then probably grenades after Nikita. But I definitely think that Wolf is easily top five, potentially the third best in the game.
I mean, why wouldn't you? It has a hitbox on the gun in case they go a little bit too heavy on the approach. It's an excellent projectile that does well at racking damage, and it's slow, but at the same time, that slowness also kind of creates some pressure of, I can't go there. It's that whole area is kind of been covered.
And that's what the power of the move is. It isn't necessarily that it's fast moving and that's going to hit you and deal a ton of damage. It's that it forces you to either shield, where he can punish that, or it forces you to jump. And if you jump, you're threatened by Wolf's meaty hitboxes. It's something that it allows Wolf to play like an option coverage-based game, where he's forcing you to do one of two options, taking away the opportunity to roll in, for instance, taking away the opportunity to go ahead and pressure you in the air with short hop aerials, and instead saying, hey, you got two things and I'm going to cover one of them. I hope you like 50-50s because that's all we're going to do for the next 5 minutes.
Yeah, it's kind of a game of heads or tails because there's a 50% chance you're going to eat something against Wolf. I mean, hey, that blaster's better than some characters in this game.
I wouldn't be surprised there.
Sorry, let's see this. Game one coming in.
So, starting out on Starterville here, Stadium.
Everyone's favorite.
And we immediately see Nair and Force Air coming out. Like, we talked about those non-committal meaty aerials, and these guys do not disappoint.
JoJ missing the grab means that Puffy starts getting some good damage in.
Yeah, 51%, just standard Wolf things. That Nair was a little bit mistimed, and actually getting the shield grab, that's really tough to do. Like, you know JoJ was ready for that.
Right now you just see aerials, and an occasional blaster coming out, so this is definitely going to decide who wins this. And Puppe's showing, with 70% on JoJ, I'm not afraid to do it.
So I think that the play style that will separate these two is if Puppy can play patiently. Like, I loved the way Zachary played Wolf, like everybody in their mother did, because that guy is amazing. Standing still and whip punishing is something that not enough players do. The average mid-level Wolf who picked up the character because he's good is going to throw out moves and oppress you with his hitbox and frame data. You can also oppress somebody by standing still and reacting to them. And that is particularly good against him.
I think standing still is actually probably the most intimidating thing you can do, because they're just standing there, menacing.
True.
What are you supposed to do?
What? Just what are you supposed to do? You give him the stanky eye. Because I ain't going over there. Why do I want to scrap?
You just stare him down, pull down the gat, and say,
yeah,
come to me.
You know, I want to scrap. You don't want to scrap? Okay, let's stare across each other for a little bit. First stock going Puppy's way. He basically got JoJ off stage, and JoJ's poor recovery.
Not quite yet.
I wasn't able to get him over there. But
no. Unfortunate SD by Puppy makes the game even.
Not quite even, because he can still play that passive game. And yeah, that forward smash is like almost unpunishable if you don't get it early. Like, the minute that animation comes out, you just got to go ahead and back off. So I'm loving the opportunity by Puppy to just toss it out.
JoJ's happy to start getting a little bit more percentage back, but it's still kind of Puppy's game. He's definitely doing a great job of taking control.
That's a wild option.
Get up Ether. It manages to get Puppy off of him just enough.
Yeah, JoJ's done it a couple times, but as we saw, if you don't hit with the meaty part of it, and if you, like, your opponent DIs it away, sometimes they can just pop out of the first hit and then fastball and punish it. So it's definitely not without its... not without its risks.
Excellent low recovery by JoJ because he does not want to get by the blaster, but get up and up tilt immediately gives him his last up.
That's an interesting response there, to parry into the forward tilt, and then you saw Puppy just stood there.
Waiting. And it worked.
Yep.
You got 43% on him already. Not afraid to show him.
So that's wild to me. Ike landed with neutral air and covered like the get up, but he mistimed it, still had enough time to get the back air out. That's insane to me.
Landing lag, what's that?
I wish this character knew. I wish this character knew the struggle.
Do you know how heavy Ragnell is? That's a big sword. That's a big boy sword.
He swings it one-handed, dog. This man...
He's beefy. Is he using Buff Ike or is he using Baby Ike?
I'm not actually not sure. I'm gonna
have to I think that's Baby.
Is that Baby Ike? No, that's Buff Ike. You can tell by the eyes.
Is it? It's hard to tell. He's moving a little bit too fast right now. But
142. He's moving fast to exit stage left here if he doesn't come back here.
Yeah, this is definitely not looking great for him. Another Aether out of getup.
And then a whiff punish there on the Nair.
That's a wacky option, but I mean, it worked for him, so can you blame him?
Puppy's starting to get a little bit antsy here. He just wanted a defensive option and then rolled through, but and eventually he's going to get a call out.
Yeah, that aggressive side B into up smash against Puppy gives Puppy game one.
And considering that Puppy killed himself at a fairly low percent, that match was not as close as it seemed. Jojo did have like an errant side B that did not snap edge, but I think he was kind of forced into that by the laser. He didn't choose the best option there. He should have just gotten hit by the laser and side beat again. But yeah, I think that he needs to change something radically in his gameplay because Puppe just seemed to have his number there.
I think he definitely needs to get it together a little bit more because, you know, you can see that everything about Wolf is so non-committal that he needs to kind of be really careful just in case he goes something a little bit too aggressive like that side beat. He can definitely eat it. And then immediately gets blasted in the face, game two. But an excellent grab. And excellent air dodge by Puppe means that he does not get stringed anymore.
And then breaking out of that little attempt there with that forward air. That's an aggressive option.
Parry from the blaster, but still eats it against Puppe's neutrals. Excellent neutral game.
Yeah, both these guys are doing a very good job. That falling, that neutral air terrifies me. Every time like I see a Wolf player go to neutral air to down smash, I'm like, that shouldn't work, but it does, and it's horrifying. It's like, I don't want to die at 60.
He just throws his leg out there, and you're like, ah, what am I supposed to do?
Oh, that's a bit unfortunate there. Jojo definitely had the right idea there with the neutral air in the back air, but couldn't quite connect with it. But I mean, when in doubt, do it again. The up air worked that time.
Forward air to up air does give him that first stock. I mean, most aerials was like does that, right?
Yes,
I mean,
sir.
We saw that when he played earlier tonight.
All right, back air. That was weird. That one didn't hit. I think he hit the auto-cancel window at the beginning of that one.
Yeah, Puppe's back throw, not quite enough to do it. He's throwing out those blasters at stage level, so Jojo recovers high, and now he's back on stage and racking up damage versus Puppe.
Yeah, this is, oh my god, don't do it to him.
Forward smash a little bit on the, he's feeling himself a little bit too much.
I mean, he didn't lose anything from doing it there, so I don't think it was like a bad option, but it was certainly a wild option. That's one of those where, like, if that was me, if I was in Puppe shoes, I'd be just giving him a side eye.
I'd be like, yeah, come on.
I'd just take the minute and I'd just look at him and be like, really, dog? You really try to do me like that?
I'd go back to neutral and stand there and wait. You really doing that to me?
Okay, yeah, you cannot do that. He tried it twice. Puppe has definitely got these parries on point.
Jojo needs
look
to work
at
on his
combo opening up with 53%.
That up smash does not quite do it for him, but you gotta respect it. And
great rollout by Jojo, recognizing that Puppe wants that down smash.
Doesn't quite do anything.
Whiff that punish real hard.
That's unfortunate because these guys are even right now.
Yeah, Puppe just exploded this thought.
But
and then he exploded literally.
Another back air. He did get sent to the Shadow Realm through those blastings.
That's the thing. It doesn't matter how much momentum you have against Ike. You're just always in danger of dying to a straight hit.
It's like Ganondorf.
You are not safe, Doug.
It's like a Ganondorf 30%, 100%. What's the difference? Doesn't one F smash, that's all I need.
Oh, Ganondorf F smash. I'm just hearing that sound like since errors. That character is just too strong. It's just dummy strong.
It's a sight to behold.
Good pop. Oh my god.
Did he just save
him?
He
saved him.
Oh
okay.
My goodness.
I guess just barely not.
All calculated.
Yeah. All according to plan. That was a great like shot there by Puppe.
An insane mental pressure by Puppe to say, I'm gonna let you live. Just kidding.
Just kidding, I got another one in the back pocket for you.
Just kidding, it's all calculated.
You don't think I got another one in the chamber, dog? Don't test me. Hit him with the Clint Eastwood, do you feel lucky?
And Puppe doing a great job just sitting there waiting, and Jojo goes into him. He rolls into him, he air dodges into him, and Puppe just takes advantage of that. But at 108%, this is looking a little bit dangerous. Oh!
There's the nair. Can't quite make anything out of it.
Everyone's
so favorite.
Oh, but.
Great back air.
Three back airs, three stocks give good Jojo
yeah.
Game two.
I mean, that's been his thing. He recognizes that sometimes attack chance, either attack canceled back air, excuse me, or just back air out of shield is a great option for like challenging these aerials when Puppy's trying to fade away. Neutral air, I mean, back air actually outranges neutral air, I learned.
Yeah. So Jojo takes game two. Let's see if he carries that momentum into game three because that was still a really close match.
Yeah, it seemed like the story of the match was that Puppe kind of blew Jojo up just consistently, but all Jojo needed was those two or three like stray hits to just end the game. And I it feels like to me what has been the deciding factor here is who gets the lead first. Like basically whoever got the lead the first stock, whoever got that first stock, seems like they were able to run away with it.
And so Unova pick stage three.
Digging it. The platforms don't give Ike like a ton of options to retreat to. It's gonna be a lot harder for him to like get the full hop jump to reset on these platforms.
And see these two are kind of dancing around each other, doing a great job shielding against those blasters. Except for that time, of course. And now Puppe's managed to kind of convert that into some hits.
Yeah, Jojo's getting a little bit wild here with these options here. Puppe's called him out three times in a row. He hasn't really gotten much out of it though. Jojo's spot dodges are actually on point, getting him out of these very dangerous spots. Neutral air can't get the dash grab as Jojo rolls away that time.
See what you get. Goes back to ledge. It's definitely a safe option and gives him a dash attack to think about.
And neutral air gets called out by the back air.
Ooh, but he rolls into that F smash by Puppe.
And that was a bit of an odd option. Like, rolling is definitely a decent mix-up every now and then, but I felt like Jojay relied on it a little bit too much, that stock. He got away with it twice. Third time, though, Pape was ready with the backhand.
And Ether had get-up like we've seen earlier in the set, but doesn't catch Pape. Pape knows. He's just going to sit there in the center.
Yeah, fool me. He's got away with the first two games, but, I mean, ain't trying to go ahead and establish a pattern here. Okay, that was so close.
That was
Pape
so
playing
close.
With fire. Like, Wolf doesn't have the best aerial mobility in his directional air dodge, so that really looked like he was going to get clipped by the back.
It was definitely close, but Pape managed to get out of it unscathed, and he is happy to let... Oh, just kind of like a little bit of a standoff right there, just kind of staring each other down, holding shields.
Yeah, it's like, you're going to let go of this, aren't you?
And excellent hold to get back to ledge. Does not want to run into
clear up air, punishing there, but this stage has a bit of a higher blast zone, so no dice on that one.
And a nice jump to bait out that up smash. Does not get anything out of it. And
up till that was sus DI, I think. I didn't see the sparks were not red.
Did not see the sparks. But of course, you also see the sparks, and they also never work. Eruption, decides to let it go, really. And
great forward tilt. Yeah, great opportunity there to call out that aggressive get up by Pape. Pape's done that a couple times, and that tilt covers so many options there. One of those that you don't see too much, but it's a great mix up. Now Pape gets the stock lead, but
and he waits for that air dodge and he gets the F smash.
Jojay is trying to hit that stock lead and say, nah, dog, we need to run this back to last stock, last hit.
But Jojay's down a stock right now, so he has to make this count, but he's definitely putting
in. Okay, that'll make it count.
He reads the roll in and gives him a nice meaty up smash to think about as he sent flying away.
Like, Pape's gotta be shook by that.
Oh, forward tilt. See, the blast line's not quite killing him because of that DI.
I can't believe that Wolf has been hit by two of Ike's smash attacks in one stock and hasn't died yet. That's stunning.
I mean, bounty hunters must know a lot of punishment because he's living at 136%.
Hit him with a, you're good, but I'm better.
What's the matter?
The most scared? That's my
Wolf's favorite. Got the most BM, like, taunts and victory screen animations. I love like this when this character wins.
I love it, but at the same time, I hate his howl this time around. The howl just does do it for
me. The fact that you can cancel it, though?
Infinite howl.
Okay, great parry into the F-tail following that dash attack. Doesn't matter if you cross me up, dog. You ain't getting away with this.
And an excellent low recovery saving him from that against that blaster. But
yeah, you can't keep doing that, man. He had to recognize Jojay, it did not work game 3 at all with that standard get up into the ether.